Okay, good afternoon all. Now I welcome you all for this today's session. In this today's session, we are going to deal with the concept of a thermoforming process, how the thermoforming process is performed on the plastic materials. Then it's a basic working principle in that we are going to study. It's a basic working principle. Then it's a different types according to the some change of the mediums, some different types are there. And then after that, we will discuss related to its basic advantages, disadvantages, and some applications. One by one, we will discuss that. And after completing this concept of thermoforming, we will move towards some, I think I have not discussed the MCQ questions in the lecture. With the answers, I will discuss it. And after that, you can also try to attempt that whichever test I have shared. Please solve that test also. Okay, I will start this session now. In this, we will see the concept of thermoforming. Okay. Now, first, we should understand that what is the meaning of thermoforming. Okay. Now, in this thermoforming, what we are going to do, whichever plastic sheet we have obtained at the end of calendaring operation, okay, to that sheet, plastic sheet, we are going to give the desired three-dimensional shape. Okay, and for doing this, to give the desired shape and size to that particular available plastic sheet, we are going to use different mediums. Okay, we are going to use vacuum medium, then pressure medium, or with the help of vacuum, with the help of pressure, and with the help of heat, we are going to change the shape of that plastic material. And depending on that, we are having some different types for the thermoforming of the plastic material. Okay, now before going in the brief discussion related to its classification, first, what is the meaning of the thermoforming? Thermoforming is nothing but, in simple words, to give the three-dimensional shape as per a requirement with the help of heat, vacuum, and pressure to the available plastic sheet. Okay, that is termed as the thermoforming. Whichever plastic sheet is available, to that plastic sheet, we are going to give the desired shape, 3D shape. Okay, now, in this thermoforming, the basic steps involved in that process, the first stage, or here I have explained it, the basic principles. Before that, going to study the basic principle, first you should understand that this process can be performed only on the thermoplastic materials. Okay, here we cannot go for the thermosetting material. Okay, as in the previous sessions, we have already discussed. I will just summarize it. What is the meaning of calendaring? Okay, whichever output you are getting at the end of this calendaring process. What is the calendaring? Okay, calendaring is nothing but with the help of these rolls, okay, different types of the rolls, whichever raw material is available, plastic raw material, that plastic raw material is converted into thin film with the help of, by applying the pressure using the rollers, okay, different rollers may be there, and at the end we will end up with the thin plastic sheet of that material. And this process we can conduct on the thermoplastic materials like PVC, or you can say that the polyethylene, etc. Okay, now after getting this fine sheet, okay, thin sheet is obtained, now I want to give the 3D shape to that thin sheet. Okay, then for that I have to apply some pressure on it, some heat and some pressure to give it the desired shape and size. That process will be termed as the thermoforming process. Okay, now this thermoforming process basically consists of three steps. In the first stage, whichever plastic material, thermoplastic material is there in the form of that sheet, we are going to heat it until it softens. Okay, we have to make it soft for the further processing. That is the first step, heating the thermoplastic sheet until it softens. Then after heating it, we are going to apply the force. Okay, whichever softened material is there, heated, you can say that is hot and pliable material. Hot and pliable means, pliable material means you can perform the bending or shaping operation on that material. It is termed as pliable. Okay. Now, on that hot, in the first stage, we are going to heat the thermoplastic sheet until it softens. Then, now that sheet is hot and pliable, now we can apply the force. Okay. Now, this force can be applied by using different mechanisms. Like you can go for a mechanical mechanism, then you can go for air pressure or vacuum pressure also. In the second step, we are going to apply the force. And in the third step, it is allowed to cool. And after that cooling, that material will acquire the desired shape and size. And we will end up with the final product. Okay. In this way, the thermoforming process consists of three stages. First is the heating, then applying the force, and third is the cooling process. Okay, just you have to provide some cooling time so that it will acquire the desired shape and size. Okay, now this basic stages are explained here only. Okay, generally this forming consists of you can say that these three stages I have summarized in the two steps only. The first stage is the heating, and second stage is forming. Okay, together here, the applying, I can say that the whichever pressure we are applying here or force we are applying, force plus cooling, that is termed as forming here. In this way, in some books, they have explained it in the two stages only. In this forming stage, force will be applied and it is allowed to cool to get the final product. Okay. Now this is the thermoforming machines, different thermoforming machines which we are using in the practical life here. In the first stage, heating is done with the help of radiant electrical heaters. Okay. And from one side or both sides, and we are going to do the heating depending on our need. Okay. And after heating, the whichever plastic or polymer material sheet is there, it is converted or formed into various shapes, either by air pressure, vacuum pressure, or by mechanical pressure, followed by the cooling to get the desired product. Okay. So this is the basics of the thermoforming process. Now, the next is the types of the thermoforming process. Okay. Here, already I have explained it. We can apply the force with the help of a vacuum medium. You can go for pressure medium, or directly you can apply the pressure also, means some with the help of compressed air you can apply the pressure also, or with the help of some mechanical tools we can apply the pressure. Now in this way, this thermoforming is classified in three types: vacuum for thermoforming, mechanical thermoforming, and pressure thermoforming. Okay. One by one, we will discuss these three thermoforming processes now. Okay, if you are having any doubt related to the basic concept of this thermoforming, you can put that in the chat box. I will wait for 1 minute here. After that, I will move towards the different types of the thermoformings. First, we will go for pressure thermoforming. Okay, if you are having any doubt, you can ask me here, or directly unmute yourself and you can ask me doubts, or you can put that in the chat box. And another basic thing you have to take into consideration, that here in this thermoforming processes, some lower pressures are required. We are not going to use the high pressure values. Okay. If you are having any doubts, you can put that in the chat box. Okay. Thermoforming, here whichever sheet is plastic sheet is obtained at the end of, or by performing the calendaring operation on that plastic sheet, we are going to apply the heat and force to convert it into the desired shape. Okay, 3D shape. This process is termed as the thermoforming. Okay. Okay, and now we will move towards the types of the thermoforming process. The first type is the pressure thermoforming. Okay, here with the help of these diagrams, I will explain this pressure thermoforming, how the actual pressure thermoforming process is completed here. Now, this red color is your preheated plastic sheet. Okay, please try to concentrate on the cursor. Okay. I will show the cursor. Please try to concentrate there. According to that, you will understand the stages. Okay. This first, this left corner diagram, left top corner diagram, this indicates the first step. Okay. Here, the whichever plastic sheet is obtained at the end of calendaring operation, that plastic sheet is collected and it is preheated, or you can say that directly, you can say that it is a heated. Why the term preheated is used here? After this, before performing or applying that force, it is heated. That's why it is termed as preheated sheet. Okay. Now here we are with the help of some clamping arrangement. That plastic sheet is clamped at the both ends, and here we are going to perform the electrical heating. Okay. Electrical heating is done in the on the stage. And after the electrical heating, this is the first stage, electrical heating is done. Then in this second stage, this here, it is placed on the mold. Okay. Whatever shape you want to give that particular sheet, you want that particular sheet in that desired 3D shape. According to that, you have to give the design to the mold. Okay. On that mold, that material is placed, or you are heated. Heated plastic sheet is placed, and with the suitable arrangement now, okay, with this suitable arrangement from the top surface, okay, we are going to apply the air pressure. Okay, here we are going to apply the air pressure. Now, due to the air pressure, what will happen? This air will flow. Okay, it will apply the force, and due to heating process, this thermoplastic material has become soft in nature, and due to this force, it will means due to that force, what will happen? Whichever material is there or that sheet is there, it get pressed against the mold wall. Okay, this is the mold wall. This is the mold wall. Due to this pressure, this sheet will get pressed against the mold wall. Okay, it will get pressed against the mold wall, and here we are allowing it to cool, and after sufficient time. And here at the bottom side, one vacuum pump arrangement is also there. You know, with the help of this vacuum pump, the extra air is taken out. Okay. And this extra air is taken out before applying the pressure. Okay. Before applying that pressure from the top surface, this whichever air is there in that mold cavity, that air is taken out. And after that, the pressure is applied. And what will happen due to the applied pressure, that sheet will get forced against the mold cavity walls, and it will acquire the desired shape and size. And some time is given for the cooling, and we will end up with the final product with the desired shape and size. Okay, this same operation I have explained with the help of one you can say that one practical example. Okay, this is the practical example. This is your final product. Okay, please first check your final product. This is the final product. You can say that one dish or one plate is there. This can be manufactured with the help of pressure thermoforming. Now, this is the clamp arrangement. Okay, this is the clamp arrangement. In this, initially, this plastic sheet is taken. plastic sheet is taken and now it is heated. Okay, this sheet is heated with the help of electrical heating. Then after that, here at the bottom side, one vacuum pump is there, and whichever air may be there, that air is removed from the this mold cavity or mold box. Any kind of air may present, it is eliminated with the help of this vacuum pump. Now, in the second stage, okay, we are going to place this sheet on this mold box, and from the top side, okay, pressure is applied by using some air pressure, or compressed air is allowed to flow through that in that mold box. So due to that pressure, what will happen here, whichever that mold cavity is having, that shape is acquired by that sheet. As due to the heat, it has become softer in nature, and due to that pressure, it will acquire the required shape and size. And after some providing some time for cooling, you will end up with this final product. This is the finished product. One dish is manufactured or one plate is manufactured. Okay, this can be used for packing of the foods. Okay, in the food industry, these kinds of the plates are used for packing the foods. Okay, this is the pressure thermoforming. If you are having any doubt, you can ask me. I will wait for 1 minute here. After this, I will move towards the next type of the thermoforming. The concept is same in all three types, just we are going to change the mode of applying the force. Okay, if you are not having any doubts, I will move towards the next type of thermoforming. This is the next type of the thermoforming, vacuum thermoforming. Okay, these are the steps involved, and this is the schematic arrangement for vacuum thermoforming. Now, in the first stage, we are going to do the heating of the sheet. Okay, now this sheet is obtained, plastic sheet is obtained by performing the calendaring operation on the raw material. In that calendaring, we are going to apply that with the help of rollers. We are going to convert that available raw material in the thin sheet, and that thin plastic sheet is, we are holding it with the help of some clamp or clamping arrangement, and we are going to heat that sheet, okay, with the help of some heating system or heaters or electrical heaters. We are going to heat that sheet. And after heating that sheet, that heated sheet, okay, that heated sheet is placed on the mold cavity, okay, mold cavity or mold box. And that mold box or mold cavity, you have to provide whichever shape and size you want for your final product. That shape and size is provided here, and it is placed on that clamp. And now here, by attaching one vacuum pump, all air is taken out from this box. Okay, all air with the help of vacuum pump, you can see that it is taken out from that vacuum box. And as this sheet is heated, it is soft in nature, and due to the pressure, when you are taking the air out from this from the bottom side with the help of vacuum pump, some okay, when force is created, and due to that force, what will happen? And this thin sheet, it will get forced against this whichever wall of this mold, okay, in this shape, or in this way it will get forced against the mold walls. And after sufficient cooling, you will end up with your final product. Now this same concept is I have collected one extra diagram, the same component, okay, whichever component, one box, we have packaging box we have manufactured here, or one plate or dish, you can say that. in the initial stage, with the help of clamp arrangement, that sheet is cold and it is heated. Okay, it is heated. Yeah, you can see here when heater, some heating arrangement is provided with the help of these heaters, it is heated. And in the second stage, this is the second stage, the air is taken out from that mold with the help of a vacuum pump. With the help of a vacuum pump, air is taken out, and due to this vacuum pump, this will get forced against the mold walls and it will acquire the desired shape and size. And after sufficient cooling, that mold box is released and we will end up with this final product, or this is the finished product obtained at the end of the vacuum thermoforming. Okay, whichever force is required to give the desired shape and size, that is applied with the help of that vacuum pump. That's why this process is termed as vacuum thermoforming. This is termed as vacuum thermoforming. Then we will move towards the next, is the mechanical thermoforming. Okay, if you are having any doubts, please ask me. Okay, then this is the last type of the thermoforming process, mechanical thermoforming. Now this mechanical thermoforming, very much similar to other two types, same stages will be there. In the first stage, heating of that plastic sheet is done. In the second stage, force is applied, and in the third stage, after sufficient cooling, it is released from the mold box or that mold cavity to obtain the final product. Now here only the medium to apply the force is different. Now in the first stage, the plastic sheet is collected, and with the help of clamping arrangement, it is you can say that you can hold it, and some heating is done on that sheet. Heating is done on that sheet with the help of some heating system or heaters, different types of the heaters. And after heating it, it is placed on the mold, and that mold cavity you have to provide the desired shape and size which you want for your final product. Then it is placed on that, and with the help of one plunger, or punch, in the second stage, after heating the sheet and it is placed on this mold, and after that the force is applied with the help of that punch or plunger. Then due to that force, what will happen due to the force, it will move in, this force will be applied in downward direction. Due to heat, that sheet has become soft in nature, and due to the force applied with the help of this plunger, the material, plastic material, will get forced against the walls of the mold, and it will acquire the shape of that mold cavity. Okay. And at the end, or you have to provide some sufficient cooling time. After that, you will end up with the final product by releasing this mold, and you have to release this plunger or punch also to get the final product. The same stages have explained with the help of that same product. Okay, you can use any preferable method to apply the force. It is not compulsory to go for vacuum thermoforming. You can say that pressure thermoforming or mechanical thermoforming. According to your means economics of your processes, you can choose it. Okay. Now in this same stages are there. This is your mold, or you can say that the mold cavity is there. And this clamp, the thermoplastic sheet is first you have to collect it, and you have to hold it, and it is heated with the help of some heaters. And with the help of one plug, or you can say that punch or plunger, the pressure is applied in downward direction, and due to heating, already it is soft in nature, then it is pressed against the mold walls to acquire the desired shape. And after sufficient amount of cooling, the final product is obtained by removing the plunger and this mold. Okay, and here one at the bottom side, one outlet is provided so that whichever air can escape from that mold. Okay, when you apply the sudden force, some air may be there, and that air may it will get escape or a way to escape from this outlet. Okay, this is air escape. In this way, the final product is obtained with the help of this mechanical thermoforming. So in this way, I have explained these all three types of the thermoforming processes. Then we will move towards some before application part. We will check the some advantages and disadvantages of thermoforming process. The first advantage is, okay, for the same kind of material, okay, from same kind of material, as it is available in the form of sheet, you can give the different kinds of shape. Okay, different shapes can be given to the same material. That is the first advantage. Then here the rate of production is very high, and whichever tooling cost and setup cost is there, it is very less in this thermoforming. Okay, that is the second advantage. High production rate with less tooling cost and less setup cost. Okay, the same is explained here. It is an efficient process because it is a cost effective. Why it is cost effective? Cost of tooling is less and setup cost is very less. And short lead time. Short lead time means the whole process. It will start from collecting the sheet, plastic sheet, to get the end product. It can be done with the shortest time possible time. Okay, that's why it is termed. That short lead time, and due to this short lead time, here we can give the any kind of the shape and size. Okay, by changing the you can say that your mold design, you can change the shape of the product. Then you can do this, apply this process to obtain larger sized products also. Okay, some flexible designs. Some whenever you are making a prototype material, any kind of component before manufacturing it, actually some prototype is made. Okay, exact replica of the final product that is made with the help of this thermoforming process only. And as here we are performing some heating operation and then we are applying the pressure, thermal stresses will be very less. Okay, temperature range is not so high. Some it is below 200 degrees Celsius. And after that, first we are heating it, and after that we are applying the force. Okay, due to that, thermal stresses are very less. So these are some advantages. Okay, I'll repeat it. You will get means from same product, different shape. The products of having different shapes and size can be obtained from the same material. And it is efficient because its cost of tooling and setup cost is very less, and high production rates can be obtained. Its lead time is very less, or short lead time. Then we can manufacture, means design flexibility is there. Different small shaped components or parts and large shaped parts can be manufactured. And the thermal stresses are very low as we are performing. Before applying the force, we are performing some preheating or heating operation. That's why thermal stresses are very less. These are the advantages of this thermoforming process. Then what are the disadvantages of this process? Okay, the first disadvantage is related to the use of material. This process is only useful for thermoplastic materials. We cannot use it for thermosetting materials. We cannot use it for thermosetting material, as the thermosetting materials cannot be rolled, or you can say that we cannot perform the calendaring on some thermosetting materials. That's why, as sheet is not available, you cannot give the desired shape and size. Okay, if it is sometimes you may end up with the sheet, but the thermosetting materials cannot be reprocessed, remolded or reshaped. That's why these materials are not suitable or eligible for thermoforming operation. Okay, not eligible for thermosets or thermosetting plastic materials. Then sometimes the parts may not be uniform throughout. Okay, whichever thickness is there, uniform thickness may not be obtained. Uniform thickness may not be obtained. And another disadvantage is all parts manufactured require some trimming operation. Some extra material may get attached to the final finished product. That's why you have to perform some trimming or small machining operation to remove that extra material from your finished product. So these are the disadvantages of thermoforming processes. Is not means this process is not eligible for thermosetting materials. Then all parts required trimming or slight machining operations, and parts sometimes may not have uniform thickness. Okay, these are the disadvantages. Now these are the some applications. Okay, some dashboard assemblies, interior door panels, interior panelings. Okay, these components generally are used in your automobile sector. Okay, in the automobile sector, or some components you can use it in the your home decoration also. Okay, whichever bumpers are there, air ducts, exterior body panels, you can say that bumpers are there, exterior bumpers or exterior body parts or of your two four wheelers. Okay, four wheelers or your two wheelers, some sitting parts of your four wheelers or two wheelers, these all are manufactured from this thermoforming operations only. Okay, dashboard assemblies, interior door panels, then exterior door panels also, sitting parts, then bumpers and air ducts, all these components are manufactured with the help of this thermoforming process only. Okay, so in this way we have completed this thermoforming process with its basic concept, basic principle, and its three types that we have covered: pressure thermoforming, vacuum thermoforming, mechanical thermoforming. Then we have discussed some advantages, disadvantages of this thermoforming process along with its applications. Okay, in this way this is the second chapter is already completed. This is I have taken just for your information purpose. And sometimes they may ask a basic question related to this thermoforming concept also, so that you just go through it. Small stages and types are there depending on the mediums. You can write it. Some advantages, disadvantages, and applications you have to write. Okay, so after this we will move towards, now I will solve some MCQ questions from your booklet. Okay, and I will instruct you to solve the second test which I have provided. Okay, okay, now here these are the MCQ questions. Okay, now I will read it and you can give me answers by entering in the chat box. Okay, the first question is like this. Which process, okay, out of this following is the most commonly used for manufacturing of the plastic components? Okay, most widely used process for manufacturing of the plastic components. If you are having the knowing the answer, you can enter that in the chat box. Okay, I will provide you the answer. The injection molding process, it is the most widely used in the manufacturing of process for the plastic components. Okay, then second question. Okay, out of these four molding processes, which molding process, okay, is used to produce hollow plastic parts? Okay, blow molding, injection molding, compression molding, and transfer molding. Out of these for molding processes. Which method is used for? Okay, A is the correct answer. Blow molding is used. Blow molding. Different water bottles are manufactured with the help of this. Okay. Sometimes there may be another option like rotational molding. Okay. If blow and rotational both options are there, then your answer will be A and B. Okay. In multiple choice questions. Then third question, compression molding process is one of the means whether it is a high cost or medium cost or low cost molding method, and this is a high cost molding method. Okay, in disadvantage of this compression molding process, you can get that answer. And question number four here, transfer molding process combines the principle of and transfer of polymer charge. Okay, transfer in the transfer molding process is nothing but the polymer charge is taken in one transfer pot and then we are compressing it, means compression. Answer is the compression. The rotational molding process is dash dash, you can say that the plastic forming process. Already I have discussed this while taking the session on this rotational molding. Rotational molding is a high temperature, low pressure forming process. Answer is fourth, D. That is a high temperature. In the rotational molding, temperature is high and pressure is low. Okay, we are heating that powder and we are rotating it. Okay, biaxially we are rotating it. Answer is high temperature and low pressure. Now, with the help of which process, hollow plastic water storage tanks are manufactured? That storage tanks are manufactured with the help of which process? You can provide an answer in chat box. Its answer is rotational molding. Storage tanks, water storage tanks are manufactured with the help of rotational molding. Then plastic sheet making process is termed as calendaring. Okay, then pot type feeder system is used in. Pot type feeder system means we are collecting the charge in the one transfer pot and it is then pressed again in a mold cavity. This is in transfer molding process. Okay, this is in transfer molding process. Then only last four questions are there. Okay, here some three, four questions are there. Okay, this is the for the next is, this is related to the thermosetting material. Okay, to get the precise dimensional ability. Now for thermosetting materials, three processes are used. Okay, compression, transfer and rotational can also be used. Here this calendaring we are only performing, means it is giving in the shape of sheet, and this is on thermoplastic material only. Okay, and then out of these two, correct answer will be transfer molding. Okay, because in compression molding we are directly applying the pressure and here we are collecting charge in one separate pot and it is then transferred in the mold cavity. That's why the desired dimensional accuracy is more in the transfer molding as compared to the compression molding. Transfer molding will provide you better dimensional stability accuracy. Then which of the following molding method is used for making long hollow pipes, that PVC pipes, whichever PVC pipes are there, or your that irrigation for that drip system, okay, drip system in your agriculture, that pipes are used, that all pipes are manufactured by the extrusion molding process. Okay, extrusion molding process, hollow pipes will be manufactured with the help of this extrusion molding. Okay, then this the process which measured quantity of preform or charge of a thermostatic polymer material is heated in the pot and it is transferred into mold cavity. Okay, heated in the pot and transferred, it is done in transfer molding. Answer is B. And the last question is, rotational molding process is used for manufacturing of. Okay. these elbow joints. This is not the correct answer. These elbow joints and these plastic bottles. Only the correct answer is water tanks are manufactured with the help of the rotational molding process. Okay. For all questions, answers I have provided here on this sheet. I will upload on the study material sheet. Chapter wise also, initially I have uploaded all MCQ questions in one sheet. When I will finish each chapter, after that I will upload this sheet in the study material sheet. Okay. In this way, our first two chapters are already completed, and already I have sent you the MCQ tests. Please attend the MCQ test for the second chapter. It will get closed after 2 hours. Okay, it will just require 20-30 minutes, or if you do it in fast way, you can finish it in 5 or 10 minutes also. Okay, only 10 questions are there. Please solve it. Now, in this way, we have completed this chapter. Okay, now I will summarize this chapter. What we have studied in this chapter. In this chapter, this is the processing of plastics. In this, we have started with the prerequisites, title of the chapter. The first, we learned processing of plastic and its basic classification. Then, which methods, processing methods are used for thermoplastic materials? Injection molding, extrusion molding, blow molding, and calendaring, these are used for thermoplastic materials. And compression molding, transfer molding, and rotational molding, these three methods are generally used for thermosetting materials. Then we have seen discussed the concept of injection molding along with its basic principle, its types, this basic principle, and then its types, advantages, disadvantages, and some applications. And next we have discussed the extrusion welding, how different kinds of different PVC, hollow PVC pipes, all these are manufactured. First we have learned the concept of extrusion molding along with the steps involved in it. Okay, this is the extrusion molding. Two types of the extruders, types of the extrusion process, applications, okay, hollow pipes, adhesive tapes, all these can be manufactured. Advantages, disadvantages. Then after that we have learned the calendaring process. Okay. Then this thermoforming, just now we have finished it. Okay. And blow molding process, we have means this, with the help of this blow molding process, we can manufacture the hollow plastic bottles, hollow pipes, different. Okay, this is the concept of blow molding process. Basic concept, steps, classification, and then how it's different types, injection blow molding process, extrusion blow molding process, and stretch blow molding process, and different materials and different components. Means its applications along with advantages, disadvantages. We have discussed this. Then after that we have discussed this thermo setting materials, processing of thermosetting materials. And that we have first learned the compression molding process with its basic working principle and parameters. This is working principle. One practical example, manufacturing of the flower pot by the compression molding process. Then advantages, disadvantages, some disadvantages, how, what is the meaning of flashing, how it is removed, applications of compression molding process. Then transfer molding process, its working principle, multi-cavity transfer molding process, then its advantages, disadvantages, different applications we have learned. Yeah. And the rotational molding process, steps involved in the rotational molding process, advantages of rotational molding process, so the disadvantages of rotational molding process, and some applications like water tanks, military utility boxes, and different urea tank, gas tank, fuel tanks, road barrier, children's slides, crates, pallets, different dustbins, then your kayaks, boats, mobile toilets, fertilizer box, okay, all these are manufactured from that rotational molding process. In this way, we have completed this okay processing of the plastics. Please attend the MCQ test today only, within the next 2 hours. After that, it will get closed. And those who have joined, you can put that, your attendance in the chat box. Thank you for attending this session. From next session, I will start the welding of the plastics. Okay, welding of plastics. Okay, also we have discussed the MCQ questions with the answers. Okay, thank you for attending the session. You can continue with your remaining sessions. Thank you very much.